Hi all. Today I'm giving a session on CCSP exam review, and it will be considered as a series one because in this series I'm covering the important areas that you must know from the domain one point of view. The domain one of the CCSP called as a cloud concept, architecture and design. My name is Prabh Nair. I will be your presenter, and I have a 14 plus years of experience in information security and consulting. For more information, you can refer my LinkedIn profile with the name of Prabh Nair. I'm also a co-founder of InfoSecTrain. I don't want to mention that in the slide because you are here for the CCSP exam review, so I thought I will focus on that content only. Thank you. So in this domain, one of the important area is basically we have is understanding the cloud computing concept. Before going to understand the cloud computing concept, and before going to cover about what is important in the domain one, let me give you a brief overview about the intent of the certification, which people used to ignore. It's very important for you to understand the objective of CCSP. It is very important for you to understand the purpose of CCSP and how CCSP certification basically enhance your career in a cloud security. So CCSP is basically a certification which basically build the profile, or you can say build a career skill set to a CSP profile. CSP. So it basically enhance and nourish your skill on a cloud security professional. Now when I say cloud security professional, what is that? Example, like there is a profile, there's a SIS company is called as a cloud customer. Example, cloud customer is the one who basically consume the cloud services. So here we have AWS, Azure, Google, Azure, Microsoft. So they are basically called as a cloud providers. So now what happen is, as you are a cloud security professional and one of the company has basically appointed you as a cloud security architect or cloud security professional, what is your role? So this company is basically deal with the AWS. This company is basically deal with the Google. This company is basically deal with the Microsoft also. So we have a different functions from a different vendors. Okay. But what is the common thing in all the three vendors is the requirement of a security. What is the common thing in all the three vendors which we are looking for? Governance, risk, compliance, and how my provider provide me a service according to my compliance requirement. How the provider is basically able to provide me service to meet my governance requirement, because by end of the day my entire business, or I'm basically hosting my entire services on the cloud provider. So my operation is basically hosted on the cloud. My technology, my application, my process, everything is hosted in the cloud. So the role of a cloud security professional who working for the cloud customers to ensure that okay, entire operation need to be run with an acceptable level of impact, and make sure the way we maintain the on-prem security of my infrastructure, the same way I need to maintain the appropriate security in the cloud environment. So it is always start with the contract. It is start with the vendor selection. It start with the architecture review. So here it's a role of a cloud security professional. He will review the contract, amend the requirements in the contract, deal with the vendor management team to understand the cloud provider perspective, understand the key management, understand the cryptography, understand how the data is going to be hosted on the cloud, what is the elements of the data, then prepare the entire solution document which basically help the cloud customer to have a better security in the cloud environment. That is why we have a role called as a cloud security professional. Now if I say here cloud security professional working for the cloud provider, example. Okay, so now what happened is when you're talking about he working for the cloud provider, okay, The cloud provider is basically building the cloud services. Okay, definitely they first design the architecture if they want to build the cloud. So when they basically build the cloud architecture, what is the role of a CSP? Involve the security requirement. Okay, when they basically build the data center, on top of it, they host the servers. Make sure the placement of the server is very important. Appropriate cooling must be there. What kind of architecture need to be there in the data center? We basically follow some kind of a design standard, and according to that only we build the cloud services, like compliance with the Uptime Institute. So who will basically guide them? It will be guided by the cloud security professional. Okay, you must have a data center with Uptime Institute of tier 1, tier 2, tier 3. In which case we need to go for tier 1, in which case we need to go for tier 2, in which case we need to go for tier 3, in which case we need to go for tier 4. That visibility will be guided by the cloud security professional. That kind of visibility will be provided by the cloud security professional to the cloud provider. If you work for the cloud provider like Azure, AWS, and Google. Along with that, when the data is going to be segregated, data is going to be stored on the cloud provider, responsibilities is a liability of the cloud provider. Definitely, accountability lies with the customer, and security is based on the trust only. If tomorrow any kind of security breach happen, then cloud provider also accountable for the cloud user. Okay, so data security, how to isolate data, how to maintain security of a data, according to what compliance data need to be maintained, according to what regulation the provider should be able to host data, process data. So in that case also the cloud security professional will guide the cloud security advisor, a cloud provider advisor. Is it clear? So in this case, cloud security professional will guide the cloud provider how to process data according to the defined regulations, and also conduct the risk assessment for the cloud architecture. So from that point of view, we need to understand CCSP. That is why in CCSP we are not covering any concept which is a vendor specific. We covering all the concept which is a vendor neutral, which can be found common in the AWS also, which can be found common in the Azure also, which can be found common in the Google also. Okay. So in this domain, if you talk about domain one, okay. So in domain one, we basically going to discuss about the building blocks which is necessary to develop cloud-based system. Confirm in, from the exam point of view, one question or two questions will be there on the building blocks. You will be introduced to the cloud computing concepts. Okay, you need to have a good understanding of scalability, virtualization, storage, networking. When I say understanding, it doesn't mean okay bookish knowledge. Now we understood what is scalability, but how to relate scalability in the exam? Okay, like I am a cloud provider, and I want to maintain the services for my customer. My customer demand is basically very dynamic, so scalability must be there because of the redundant architecture. Understood? So this is how the intent of the concept you should know. So scalability, virtualization, type of virtualization, storage encryptions, networking. Okay, that you need to understand. We also need to understand about the cloud reference architecture. See, when you audit a cloud provider as a cloud customer, or when you work for the cloud provider as a cloud security professional, visibility is required for the security. So when you work for the security of the cloud infrastructure, without visibility you cannot do that. So for that we need an architecture, and once you have an architecture, you need to have an understanding of an architecture. So that understanding is required in the CCSP. And also the last thing which you need to understand about the cost benefit analysis and evaluation of a cloud provider. What kind of a certification you look for when you basically finalize the cloud provider. So that understanding is also required in the CCSP. So in this case, if you can see the slide, the first thing is called as a cloud computing definition. So that is something which is required. So you need to know the definition of a cloud computing. I would recommend you can see the definition. They have used the NIST statements in both, which is called as the CBK second edition and the CYBEX. Another important thing which is required is basically called as a cloud computing roles. Okay, so we have a three type of cloud computing roles. One is basically called as a cloud service customer. Second is basically called as a cloud service provider. And the third is basically called as a cloud service partner. So when I talking about cloud service customer, cloud service provider, and cloud service partner, okay, If you want more information about these roles, because this is also called as an activities, so don't get confused in the exam if they basically mention instead of roles activities. Okay, this is also called as an activity. For this, I will recommend you to read ISO, IEC 17789. It is very important for you to review the responsibilities of the cloud service customer, cloud service provider, and cloud service partner. Partner, I can give you right now a common example called as a cloud broker. Okay. I won't have a time currently to discuss about cloud broker here, but I'm just giving an example here, cloud broker, because it is a party that engage in support of or auxiliary or activity of either cloud service provider or cloud service customer. So when you basically deal with the different kind of cloud server service providers and all that with the help of broker, it can basically reduce the task of the cloud customer. So cloud broker is very important for the exam. Actually, the detailed activities of the cloud service customer, detailed activities of a cloud service provider, and detailed activities of a cloud service partner, it means what comes under what. Okay, all are basically important in the exam. And when I review the documents of second edition, Cybex, and all that, I could not able to find this information there. And I was surprised I got those information in the ISO 17789. And people failed in CCSP because of this only, because we have a very limited resource of the CCSP. So I will 100% recommend you to review the ISO 17789 document, where you will discuss, we are going to understand about the different kind of cloud computing roles. Okay. Next thing is called as a cloud computing characteristics. So when you're talking about the cloud computing characteristics in the cloud, so whenever we go for any cloud provider, okay, we look for the some key requirements, okay, that must be there in the cloud provider. So like on-demand self-service, okay, then we have a multi-tenancy. Any question talking about multi-tenancy, it is always a concern. Multi-tenancy is a concern, always remember, because one tenant data is basically shared with other tenant data, and most effective security control is the encryption. Remember, any question talking about multi-tenancy, and if we get a two options like contract and encryption, then answer is encryption as a preventative control. Because as a cloud service customer, for me, I would like to go for a preventative solutions. Definitely, contract will come into the picture when there is an incident is occur and when we need to establish the responsibility and accountability. But why should I wait for the disaster to be occur? So most effective security is basically the encryption. So encryption is basically the solution. The provider must be providing a scalable services, and scalability mean manage my demand high and low. And that is only possible when the cloud provider using a virtualization infrastructure. Scalability is basically mapped with the elasticity. You should know the thin line difference between the scalability and elasticity. What will be the preference, scalability over elasticity? Okay, in which condition we should go for major services? What is a primary requirement for a cloud service customer? What is a primary requirement for the senior management? So that is also need to understand, like major services, like, you know, how much you have utilized. That is a primary requirement for the cloud service provider, or sorry, cloud service customer from the management point of view, because this is basically mapped with the business value and all that. I can take this example with the point of view Uber. So in Uber, what happened? We have a pool of cars, so demand can be scalable. Okay. And whatever I basically use, I will get a bill receipt for that. Okay, so I will be more interested to know about how much I basically pay for the services. So by this way, I can do my 6 months of forecasting and 7 months of forecasting. So definitely the senior management business team, when they basically go for the cloud provider, they want the major service to be part of their service category. So these are the key requirement that must be there in a cloud provider. Okay, then we have a broad network access and rapid elasticity. If I'm using a cloud provider as a hot site, okay, as a secondary site, okay, suppose we have an on-prem data center and I'm migrating that on-prem data center on the cloud, because I'm using cloud as a BCDR here, so I will definitely look for the broad network access and rapid elasticity, because it must be available and it must be accessible from anywhere. And because of pool of resource, I will not face any kind of a shortage of resources. So these kind of understanding is required. Example, when I say scalability, so cloud service can be easily meet those needs either temporary or long term in a much more cost efficient manner. Okay, so because new computing resources can be assigned and allocated without any significant additional capital investment on the part of a cloud provider. So that is called as a scalability. Okay, so you should know the thin line difference between the scalability, elasticity, because elasticity offer flexibility. So rapid elasticity, scalability, and broad network access is the key feature for BCP DR in a cloud environment. So whenever I will go for a cloud provider, or when I go for the cloud services, and I want to use cloud services for my backup continuity, I will definitely look for these key requirements. So this is how the question will be asked in the exam. So if you know the concept, you can able to relate this concept, you know, in the problems which you get in the exam, because in the exam they will ask you about the solution of the problems. Customer is continuously facing some kind of a downtime and all that, and their demand is increase and decrease according to requirement. So as per the cost benefit analysis, what is the key requirement you will look for the cloud provider? Rapid elasticity, because it must be available whenever it required. So it immediately available. That is called rapid elasticity, which we are looking in the BCP. Or example, like this kind of question will be there that, okay, you are using a secondary hot site, but still you want to go for a cloud. What is the biggest reason of basically going for the cloud instead of going for the secondary own site? Because of the rapid elasticity, because I want to achieve my defined MTD. Okay, I want to achieve my defined MTD and I want to achieve my defined RTO. Because I know that, okay, in the cloud, my MTD and RTO will be low, right? That is one of the biggest reason that I'm going with the cloud provider as a secondary site instead of having own site. Okay, one more reason is because of CapEx to OpEx. So now you understood how the perspective of the CCSP you need to understand. The third thing which is important is called as a building block technology. So when I say building block technology, in this section, we're going to discuss about the virtualization. So we have a type 1 and type 2. Then we need to understand the type of storages, okay, networking, the database, and the orchestration. So you need to have a good understanding of orchestrations. You need to have the good understanding of the type of virtualization. What are the concerns we have in a virtualization? What kind of vulnerabilities we have in the virtualization? VM guest escape. I'm just giving an example, okay? Then cloud orchestration, because that is cloud orchestration is all about your automations. Okay, so these are the things which you need to understand from the part one of a domain one. Okay, I hope it basically clear your doubt regarding what you need to read when you reading this particular context. So confirm areas will be the cloud computing will be there. So you should not ignore that. And computing activity, you need to have a good understanding. That is a moral of the story. Don't ignore this. Okay, have a good understanding of this section. Second part of the domain one is called as a cloud reference architecture. See, one thing we need to understand when it comes to cloud. Okay, sorry for my communication. So when it comes to cloud, okay, cloud is categorized into two parts. One is called as a service and one is called as a deployment. We have a three type of service: IaaS, PaaS, and SaaS. Okay, deployment is basically we have a public cloud, private cloud, community, and hybrid. Okay, so I already covered the cloud computing activities in my previous diagram. Okay, if you want to know those activities, that is also mentioned in the NIST document, which is called as the computing synopsis and recommendation. You will get all those information there also, the responsibilities. It is mandated. So if you are unable to find the ISO document, because that is a paid document, you can refer the NIST cloud computing synopsis. Cloud computing synopsis. You will get those detailed activities of what are the activities we have in the cloud provider, cloud customer, and cloud partner. If I have, I will definitely share, but I will try to share the link of that particular document in the chat box or in the comment section, okay, in the description of the video. So cloud computing activity is confirmed in the exam. Another important areas we have called cloud service category, as I discussed. Should I go for SaaS or should I go for IaaS or should I go for PaaS? It's completely depending upon my business requirement. Another important thing is that who will responsible for what? I was just giving one example here. I have taken the NIST reference here that, okay, what is the responsibility of the cloud provider and what is the responsibility of a cloud consumer? Okay, so they can also ask this kind of questions in the exam. In the IaaS, who basically own the hardware, who basically own the middleware? The same reference you will get in the same NIST document. Okay, so it is mandatory for everyone to review the NIST document, especially about the responsibilities. Okay, who is responsible for the data security and governance? See, data security and governance in all the three cases, it's a responsibility of a customer. But we have other things also, okay, that we need to understand. In the IaaS, we basically get a one some dump server. You will decide your OS recommendations and everything. OS you can install. In the SaaS, you will get a solution from the cloud provider. In the PaaS, we get a platform. Always a biggest concern to deal with the platform as services because you're migrating your application on the cloud. Vendor contract, standard API, vendor lock-in all need to be reviewed before going for the services. So that understanding is basically required. Then we also have a cloud computing service capability, like what is a application capability types, okay, what is basically the platform capability type and what is the infrastructure capability type. Actually, this is basically the second part of the service category. Okay, each and every services, when you basically go in detail, then they also explain about why should I go for application, why should I go for platform, and why should I go for the infrastructure. Application mean software as a services. One more thing you need to remember, in the SaaS you have a least control, in the IaaS you have a most control, but the challenges always come in the PaaS environment. Okay, so you can expect a good number of questions on the PaaS environment. One more thing about a cloud shared consideration. There is a one statement is called as a cloud shared consideration. So when you're talking about cloud shared consideration, data security and GRC is a accountability of the customer. Always remember, physical security in all the three is a responsibility of a cloud provider. CSP has a responsibility for a security of the cloud, and customer has a responsibility for security in the cloud. I repeat my statement again, cloud service provider has a responsibility for a security of the cloud, overall cloud, whereas the customer has a responsibility for security in the cloud. It means how the data is going to be stored in the cloud. Okay, so they will take the complete accountability for that. I can give you an example here. Suppose there is a data subject. He went to one bank. Okay, bank is basically using one SaaS application which is hosted on the cloud. Example. Sorry for my handwriting. So now what happen is tomorrow bank going to use the application of a cloud, so data is on the cloud. So tomorrow if cloud is basically compromised or any data breach happen, bank is the one who face the RBI. Bank is the one who face the regulatory requirement. Bank is the one who face the user also. Right? Because I am the customer. I will go to bank. Hey boss, my data breach happened. My data got compromised. I can see my bank details are out. What is this? What the hell is this? So I have a complete right to sue the bank. Bank will basically sue the cloud provider. So there is a strong agreement, strong contract will be there between the cloud provider and bank. The reason why CSP profile coming in the market, which is called as a cloud security professional, because cloud providers are normally used to parse the agreement according to their requirements. And lack of awareness among the bank or lack of awareness among the cloud consumer, they basically go with their agreements and SLA, which is drafted by the cloud provider. So hidden tactics about vendor lock-in, data segregation, GRC responsibility, that coming into the picture when the cloud security professional has joined the organization. And that also bring the more visibility between the cloud service provider and cloud service consumer. Now, cloud service consumer understood, okay, this is how also we can do the agreement changes, and this is how the agreements can be modified, and this is how the responsibility can be transferred. So that is why this kind of certification like CCSP, CCSK, it basically enhance the awareness among the cloud service consumer when they're basically consuming the cloud services from the provider. Okay. So it is very important that, okay, data security in the cloud is a customer responsibility, and security of the overall cloud is a responsibility of the cloud service provider. So ISO 17789 and NIST Cloud Computing Reference Architecture, these are the two reference architecture people basically use, the organization is basically used to accomplish their cloud security goals. Okay. Another important thing is basically need to be understand is basically called as a cloud deployment model. I already discussed cloud deployment model, public cloud, private cloud, hybrid cloud, and community cloud. In which condition we can go for a public cloud? What is the pros and cons of the public cloud? Okay. In which condition we go for a hybrid? Any question talking about cloud bursting, BCPDR? Remember, the answer will be hybrid cloud. This kind of perspective you need to consider. Whenever we go for a hybrid cloud, contract play a very important role. Data portability play a very important role. Okay, and data standardization is very important, because in the case of disaster, we are migrating a data from on-prem to the cloud. So that understanding is required. I'm just covering right now very high level, because I used to cover in my sessions. My trainers used to cover in the sessions. The next part is basically called as a cloud shared considerations. Shared considerations like interoperability, portability, reversibility, availability, security, privacy, resilience. These are basically some of the metrics we have. We look for, or we this responsibilities is basically shared between the cloud provider and cloud customer. Okay, these are the metrics we have. We look for, we focus more on these metrics when we deal with the cloud providers. Okay, it is very important for you to understand all these metrics. Example, like difference between the interoperability and portability, availability, security, privacy, thin line difference between the resiliency and availability, service level agreement, what need to be included in the service level agreement. All those things is basically covered in the cloud shared considerations. Okay, like it mean these are the common thing which is shared between the cloud provider and cloud customer. So example, I am a cloud customer, I'm going for the cloud provider. SLAs is there, which is basically define the responsibilities, which mutually both should be know that. What regulatories we need to follow, both need to be know that. Portability, interoperability of an application, both need to be know that. So these considerations you can able to understand only when you refer the Sybex, you will get a better understanding. I would recommend you to go through the NIST document. It give you the better understanding of those topics, but it is very important. Please, please, please do not skip that particular topic. The 20, the CCSP, the new revision of the syllabus, which has happened between 2018, 2019, okay, introduce a new topic which is called IoT. Okay, very important for the exam. IoT is very important in the exam. You need to understand the type of cloud we have for the IoT. Okay, then we blockchain, artificial intelligence, and machine learning. Now, what is your learning? Okay, what will be your learning from the IoT, blockchain, artificial intelligence, and machine learning? That we need to understand first. So when talking about, when we're going for the IoT, blockchain, artificial intelligence, and machine learning, what is a common thing in all these services is required the massive infrastructure. Okay, required the massive infrastructure. So that is why it is very important for you that, okay, for these services we have a cloud services. So cloud service basically meet the requirement which is required for the IoT. Okay, so that is basically we called. So that is why IoT, blockchain, and everything is very important. Okay, there is a dedicated cloud we involved for the IoT, that you need to know that. Okay, you can refer the book, you will get understanding about why should I go for a cloud for the IoT. Today we're taking care of the smartwatches and all that, all data they process on the cloud. Okay, how the cloud can be utilized for the IoT services, how the cloud can be utilized for the blockchain, how the cloud is can be used for the machine learning, because machine learning required the massive infrastructure. Okay, so how it we're going to be use that? So that understanding is required. So you can say like that in domain one, when I say new content, when the new revision was happened, it was this content was introduced: IoT, blockchain, artificial intelligence, and machine learning. Summary here is why we need a cloud for this. Because of two reasons: massive infrastructure is required to process this information, and massive data structure is required to process this information with better resiliency and lesser cost. That is why we basically go for the cloud services to utilize these services. Now the next thing is basically called as a understand the cloud, understand the security concept relevant to the cloud. Oh, very, very important section is basically this only. Example, you need see in a cloud, the most important thing is basically called as the encryptions, because you don't have an end-to-end control. Okay, you don't have an end-to-end control of the infrastructure. The only effective solution is the encryption only. When the data is reside in the cloud provider, because of multi-tenant, there is a concern that your data can be shared with the other users. There is a concern because segmentation, what we have, it's a logical segmentation only. Okay, we don't have any physical segmentation because everything is on the resource pool. So most effective security that you can consider is the encryption only. And for the encryption, key management play a very important role. One thing you need to remember: if key is compromised, data is compromised. If key is lost, data is lost. Okay, so key encryption all are basically impact the availability directly or indirectly. So that is why key management is very important. How to utilize the key management, pros and cons of the key management, how to manage the keys in the cloud environment, that is important in the exam. To understand better key management, I would recommend you to refer the CSA white papers, which is dedicatedly on the encryption key management, which is highly testable in the exam. We have a two type of key management: client side and server side key management. That is also required for the exam. How to destroy data in the cloud, that is called as a crypto shedding. Very important for the exam, crypto shedding or crypto eraser. Okay, where we encrypt the data and we upload the data in the cloud. Then we also need to understand the type of access control we have. Okay, like by implementing a DRM and IRM solutions, which is also important in the exam. How the DRM and IRM can impact the functionality, that is also important in the exam. Then we also need to understand the type of security we have in the virtualization type 1 and type 2. Okay, type 1 is basically more secure than type 2, but what are the concerns we have with the hypervisor? Live example is machine, virtual machine is basically stored as a file only. So portability is a concern because it can be dumped in any hard disk and we can move the machine from one location to another location. What kind of a security we have in the containerization? Containerization is a new topic which is added in the CCSP syllabus. And then we also need to understand about the different kind of a threats. Okay, different kind of a threats. That is also you need to understand. The biggest threat in the cloud environment is the data loss and data disclosure, because you uploading a data in the cloud, so data is basically transit over the network. So you need to have a good understanding of the common threats, especially in the CCSP data covered about the data loss. So for data loss, we have a DRM solutions and DLP. Then we have a data breach. Encryption is a solutions. Okay, data breach. Then we have other threats also. When you refer the white refer the book, you will get a better understanding of that. You need to have a better understanding of the media sanitization. Definitely, you cannot physically destroy the media. You can only logically erase the data. And most effective destruction process we follow in the cloud is crypto shedding. That you need to remember from the exam point of view. So summary here is security aspects we are covering in this particular section. Okay, the summary here is we are covering the security aspects in the cloud environment. The next part is the most important part again: cloud secure data lifecycle. You need to have a good understanding of the CSU SAD. So you need to have a good understanding of the CSU SAD. One or two questions will be there in the exam on CSU SAD. It is quite testable in the exam. Create, store, use, share, archive, and destroy. In which phase what activity happened, or arrange in the sequence, match the following. You classifying the data, you achieving in which phase. But question is why it is testable in the exam. See, as a cloud security professional, when you basically store data in the cloud, data basically store in a different states. And according to that states, we need to maintain the security, like data at rest, data in transit, and data in use. Example, in the use, we need to use two solutions, DRM and DLP. In data in transit, you need to use SSL and TLS. In data at rest, we need to have an encryption. So in which case, what need to be done, what kind of activity happening in each phase, please do not skip that. It's very important. So sequence is CSU, SAD. Crypto shedding occurs on which phase? The answer is destruction. In which phase we refer the retention policy and archival policy, which is called as the archive stage. Okay. We basically use cloud as a secondary backup. So we have a different kind of a scenario, like cloud as a BCDR, between two cloud provider BCDR, or on-prem to cloud as a BCDR. So you need to have a good understanding of the different type of BCDR scenario. You need to have a good understanding of a BIA from a cloud point of view. Example, what is the biggest reason we are using a cloud as a secondary hot site? Because of MTD and RTO, because of RPO, because of the cost, because of the rapid elasticity. So BIA is important. I would recommend you to refer the BIA and BCP topic from the CISSP. Those who are not CISSP, I will recommend you to review the Kelly video of BCP. You can refer the Larry video of BCP. You refer Prashant Mohan notes for the BCP or DR. You can refer Luke Ahmed group for the BCP DR. It's very important for the non-CCSP aspirants who are preparing for CISSP. CISSP aspirant preparing for CCSP, I will recommend them to refer the CISSP document BCP DR, because that language will definitely influence your preparation for the CCSP exam. Okay, so refer the Kali video, it is free. Luke Ahmed videos, Prashant Mohan Memory Palace. Okay, so you can refer these documents, resources for understanding of BCP, but it is mandatory. Do not depend upon the single document or single content which is mentioned in the instructor, the second edition of a CBK and the Cybex. Okay. That will not be enough for the CCSP exam point of view, but it will be advantage for those who are already CISSP. They are already familiar with the language of the BCP, which is testable in the exam, but those who are not, highly mandatory for them to refer those resources. Then cost benefit analysis is another important thing. What is the difference between the vendor lock-in, interoperability, portability? In which conditions we need to go for interoperability, portability? So you need to have a good understanding of that. Then we already covered the type of services. Now we're going to discuss about what kind of a security we have in the SaaS, IaaS, and PaaS. I don't much have a time to discuss in detail about this, but small hint I'm giving you here. Suppose in a SaaS, we concern about input validation because application is developed by the vendor. Okay, so we have access of the application also. We can test this application. We can see what kind of a bug in the application we have. When you're migrating the application in the PaaS environment, what is the security concern we have in the PaaS and how to tackle that? That is important in the exam. Okay, and what are the countermeasures we have for that particular security services? So that is important for the exam. So you can see like that possibility of that topic is basically less as compared to what topics we have covered in the past. So I would suggest to give attention to those topics which I have recommended in this particular video. The next part, which is basically called as a, evaluation of a cloud provider. See, first of all, you're migrating your operation on the cloud. Okay. The first thing what you're doing, you're migrating your operation on the cloud. So you need to trust their cloud infrastructure. So like the way we basically evaluate the supplier for any kind of services, same like we need to evaluate the cloud provider. But the question is, what kind of a certification I will look for? So we have a ISO 27017. I must say that, okay, the CCSP exam actually based on the language of NIST and ISO 27017. Okay, it is basically a guideline for information security control that is applicable for the provision and use of a cloud services. Then we also have a common criteria. As I said earlier, again, advantage for the people who completed the CISSP. Common criteria is testable in the exam, especially in the CCSP also. Common criteria is also called as ISO 15408. You need to have a good understanding of the protection profile. You need to have a good understanding of a security target, which is basically covered in the common criteria. Okay. So again, I will recommend you to refer the CISSP documents, which basically give you visibility about this common criteria. And along with that, we have FIPS standards. Okay, you need to have a good understanding of the different type of FIPS 1402, which is basically considered as a secure cryptography solution product. Okay, so it is basically used to certify the devices. Okay, 1402 is basically used to obtain the cryptography devices solution. So any cryptography solutions we have, if they basically obtain the FIPS 1402, it is a minimum security they have maintained. So we have a different kind of a level here, 1401. 2, 3, 4. The 4 is basically considered as the highest secure one. So when I go for a cloud provider and they have encryption solutions also in that, I will ask for the certification. Yes, we are FIPS 1404. Oh, then I can trust because FIPS 1404 is considered as a highest security solution. Along with that, something which is missed in the book is called FISMA. It is very important for you to refer the FISMA also. Okay. It is very important for you to refer the FISMA and the FISMA accreditation. Okay, so FISMA accreditation is there, which is also testable in the exam, which is missing in the book. So FISMA law is basically important for the non-government cloud services who are going to use in the cloud provider, and FISMA audit. So this is all from my side in the domain one. Okay, I will wait for your comments. I will wait for your feedbacks. Okay. And based on that feedbacks and all that, I will try to improve my domain two session also. Definitely this recording or this session you can refer week before the exam, which give you a good visibility about your preparation towards the CCSP. Thank you team for your time.